Simple straight.
I can't afford this life no more.
Just getting lucky. I'll give you a chance to win your money back.
You want in, boss?
We have business to discuss, Paulie.
We're in it now, boys.
One of our associates at the coroner's office sent this over. Corpse's name is Giolotti.
You recognize him?
Sure. That's one of the punks we ran out of the neighborhood.
Now he got the bullet in the back of his head?
Yeah. We capped him.
Well, the cops ought to thank us. We did him a favor. The guy was a rapist, boss.
Yeah? Well, he was also a city councilor's son. You want to drive a politician into Morella's arms? There's no better way than killing off his family.
Oh, Christ.
It gets worse. You left another guy in the wreck?
Yeah, but he was dead when we got there.
You gonna tell me he was the president's nephew or something?
Two in the head, Paulie. If you're gonna do a job, do it right.
He made it?
Yes. He spent the week in St. Mary's, but he pulled through.
Can he point a finger at either of you?
I don't know. Maybe.
Okay. Look, we're gonna kill two birds with one blast. Galati's funeral's today at St. Michael's. Sam, you're gonna attend. Sit in the back and try to spot the lucky bastard.
How will I recognize him?
He'll be the one who just crawled away from a car wreck.
His arm is broken. Look for a sling.
Sam's gonna need a little distraction if he's gonna clean up your mess.
Are you sending Tommy to dip his wick?
Is it brothel?
A gentleman's club, just down the street from St. Michael's. The Don has invested a lot of money in it over the years.
So, me and Sam.
Regardless, the owner has suddenly decided to do business with Morello instead of us.
You want me to go remind him of his obligations?
Yes. Then blow the place up.
What?
Morello wants to take businesses away from us? He'll inherit craters.
Look, Tom, we can't send Paulie and Sam since all the ladies know them already. They'd never make it through the front door. But you can walk right in.
Okay. What about the manager?
Take care of him wherever you find him. If any of the horse see it, well, it'll be a warning. Once he's out of the way, head to his office on the top floor. Grab any documents and money you find there, and place the explosives.
Vincenzo will see that you have what you need.
And you think the blast will be big enough to give me cover?
Yeah. But be smart. Only take a shot if you know you won't get made.
Tommy, one more thing. One of the girls is passing Morello information about our operations. Before you blow the place, you'll need to take care of her, too.
You want Tommy to kill a twist? Come on, Frank.
It's just bad luck this falls to Tom. But we gotta protect the family.
Her name is Michelle. She's usually working one of the upper rooms. Her photo is in the folder.
You boys clear on everything?
Yeah.
Tom.
I got it, boss.
Then get it done.
All right, let's go.
He wakes up one
night. Go see Vinny. Somehow, I'll meet you here.
I heard about their misfortune, Tom.
We're gonna fix it.
A lesson learned, I think, eh?
Heard you in the market for something that goes boom. Give those girls a squeeze from Uncle Vin, huh?
Not today, Vinny.
Don't go anyplace yet. Gotta hear me out on this. It's about the girl.
Michelle?
Right. You don't have to rub her out. Just make her disappear.
You know her?
Yeah. I've been with her a few times. She's a good egg, Tom. Just maybe not so bright. She doesn't deserve to get plugged just because she likes listening to me talk.
You think she'll leave town?
When she understands what'll happen otherwise, yeah, she'll leave. Here's 100. Give it to her. And make sure she gets far away.
Okay, sir. I'll see what I can do.
That's all I'm asking. Let's go.
about the situation. Infantry troops then entered several of the demonstrators' encampments, firing...
She's the one. From the racetrack, right?
Tom, that was the last time we're ever going to talk about her. Condolences.
Good luck.
You too.
You behave yourself in here, okay?
Know where I can find the manager?
Just watch the door, pal.
Hey, handsome. You here for a girl, drinks, or a mix of the two?
A girl. And I got some business with your manager, too.
A girl I can help you with. Come through. Find a girl you like, and you can both get better acquainted upstairs. There's no rush, so get a drink, relax, and enjoy yourself.
Hey, good afternoon, sir.
Just how I like them.
Why don't you buy me a drink?
Because you're not the dame I'm after. You know Michelle.
I'm new here, baby. I don't know a thing.
I need to speak to Michelle.
The only girls available are the girls you can see. Find one you like and don't make a fuss.
I need to talk to the manager.
Yeah, head straight through to the lounge. You're with our new business partners, I assume.
What's a handsome man like you doing in a place like this?
Looking for a girl named Michelle.
She's busy upstairs, but I'm free.
You looking for a good time? Come this way, sweetie.
Nah, I'm looking for a friend. Michelle.
Sure you are. Come to my room and tell me all about her.
I just want to talk.
You know, I get to hear that a lot. I bet you're not like all the other guys either, are you?
Nah, not really. Where's Michelle?
Upstairs in 208. That all you want?
That's all I want.
Wish they were all like you, sweetheart.
You, Michelle?
What's it to you?
Fella named Sam is one of your regulars.
Maybe. There's a lot of guys named Sam.
You know him. Works for Don Celieri. Maybe you got him talking about our business from time to time, and maybe Don Morello offered you some money to spill what you heard.
No, Sam, trust me. I don't say nothing. He knows that.
But Don's losing a lot of money because someone can't keep their mouth shut.
I was just bumping guns with some of Morello's girls. I didn't mean nothing by it. Tell him I'm sorry. Tell him that I won't never open my mouth again.
Shh. I know.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You scared then? Good. Don't you ever forget how it feels to be this scared. To know you're just one twitch away from a hole in the ground. Because if you ever show your face in this town again, they're going to find you with 2 1/2. Do you understand? Lucky for you, Sam's got a big heart. Get dressed and make tracks. This place is going to blow soon.
Thank you.
Just don't come back and we're square.
Here now! Yeah, I'm out! Cover me!
before he's back on street level.
I want everyone we've got on this guy. Get up there and bring him down.
No matter how far we've fallen, we can find redemption in death. Now, William, he was a sinner, yes, but he was also a loving son, a protective brother, and a loyal friend. And for those virtues, we pray that his soul will find salvation. And now, I believe one of Billy's closest and dearest friends would like to say a few words.
Thank you, Father. I just wanted to pay my respects. Billy, I never said this, but I consider you my brother. I can't even count all the times you saved my ass from a beating. So I don't know how I'm gonna...
What are you doing?
Wait, that's the guy. That's the guy who killed Billy!
Please!
Jesus, what was Billy involved in?
Over here!
could have stopped all this days ago. This is the way this city works. You think I'm enjoying this?
What have you done? Murder in the house of God.
These men were criminals, Father. Thieves. Rapists. Killers.
And God would have embraced them if they'd asked for forgiveness. Now, which one of these men might have sought redemption by working with the poor? Which one might have saved just one life?
None of us, Father. You bastard. If you have any confessions to make, you better do it quick.
No more bloodshed, please!
I'm sorry, Father. Consider this an act of divine retribution.
That make us even?
Sure. For now. For your trouble, Father.
I don't want your blood money.
You took theirs. Not a lot of difference from where I'm standing. That should be enough dough to patch up the bullet holes and keep you quiet.
When the cops come, you tell them the gunman who did this had East Coast accents. Must have been from out of town, right?
I won't lie. But I won't say anything at all.
Good. Be a shame if we had to come back here.
Where the hell were you?
As soon as I walked into church, the crew recognized me. They followed me straight back out.
Where are they now?
The same place as all these guys. Come on, we gotta go. Go grab some first aid.
Form a perimeter around the church, boys.
They
don't let him out.
I'm in a hurry.
Are you kidding?
Tony, we can run find another dessert, but we got cops everywhere.
They keep coming.
Get to inside.
They keep coming.
Before that goes any further.
They keep coming!
Well, today didn't turn out like I expected. Yeah, it was messy, but I got everything done.
Everything?
Yeah.
everything.
They giving up yet?
I don't think so.
They must have called out every cop in the city.
The guy's gotten away in North Park someplace. Keep looking. He'll turn up.
Come on, Tommy. Lose him.
I'm trying.
All officers, search is called up. Repeat.
Okay. We lost him.
Thank Christ.
Gonna be trying to forget today for a long time.
You're telling me.
Let's get back to the bar. We gotta lie low.
The way this all went down, we gotta lie low for weeks.
The priest will keep his trap shut. Don't worry.
Jesus Christ, Tommy. You're confessing to a shootout in a church.
And I ain't even to the hard stuff yet.
You know, I could take you in right now, put your bowling bars and tell you you're old and gray.
Maybe. If you think you can make any of it stick. But then you'd never know about Murillo.
Hey, fellas. Sorry to keep you waiting. My shift has started. What you having?
2 lunch specials, please. And more coffee. You know what? Let's bring the whole pot. All right, we've come this far together. What kind of heat did you get from the church?
It's a strange thing. Nothing really came of it all. Always figured Salieri paid off someone somewhere because it wasn't even in the papers. We just had to lay low for 7-8 months. The cops kept showing up at the bar just to remind us they were watching. And Frank caught wind that Morello was helping Galati get reelected, hoping he'd go after the Don.
We recovered some account books from Morello's offices. 33 was a pretty good year for him.
Bastard knew we were bleeding out before we did. While we were busy keeping our heads down, he started moving in on our rackets. Quiet at first, a few trucks go missing. Top burner has one too many highballs, drives off a bridge. One of our regular pickups suddenly closes up shop, moves upstate.
You knew he didn't catch on?
Not me. I think maybe Polly smelled something. But even with the cops looking over our shoulders and Morello circling, we were still making good money. And with the Don worried about keeping the heat off, we didn't have much to do, except drink, have a few laughs. Every time I went into Salieri's, there was Sarah. So it was a good year. Until Frank.
Coletti, Don's consigliere.
Yeah, that's right. He set me straight. He set us all straight.
There's a lot of buzz around town about you guys.
Yeah, we got into a little scrap last night. It's no big deal.
I don't care about the bar fight, Tom. I care how it looks when you walk into a club and buy everyone around.
We gotta do something with her, though.
Then blow it at the track on Sunday. Or take a dame to a show. Or invest it, for Christ's sake.
You want me to become one of those Wall Street boys?
Don't sass me, Tommy. I'm trying to teach you the ropes so you don't get strangled by them. You ever have a dog, Tom?
Sure. A little mutt when I was a kid.
When I was 8 or 9, before I came over from Sicily, I had this beautiful skinny Cerneco dell'Etna. Like a little greyhound. Fastest dog you've ever seen. That's how I met the Don. We started setting up races together, betting on her with coins and rifle shells. There wasn't another dog that could catch her. She never lost. Until the day she did. We were only out a pocket knife, but I never saw the Don so angry.
She got old on you?
No. Pregnant. She went into heat, got out of the yard, and every dog in town had a turn. You're like that dog, Tommy. Every time you flash your money around, you're a bitch in heat, and everyone in that club is now looking to fuck you. And once you get fucked, you're no good to us. Do you understand?
You made your point.
Good. Because you need to think about your career here. Look, Paulie's at his ceiling. He's the guy we want in a tussle, but he's not smart enough to run anything. Sam is loyal, but he has no vision. But you, Tommy, you could run this town someday.
I appreciate that, Frank. So, what happened to the dog?
The Don tried to drown her. I broke his nose. You can let me off here. Give Sarah my best, Tommy.
Back then, everything went through Frank. The plans, the orders, the money. You could get the call day or night.
Ah, Tommy. Frank says to wait for him in the garage out in the back. Eh? You got the job, I think.
Thanks, Luigi. Sarah's cooking. She's bringing something over.
In this rain? She's a good girl.
I'll see you tomorrow, Luigi.
Back in the day, when the boss was still with Pepone, we got called.
Thanks for waiting, Tom. The Don and I had to go over last month's numbers again.
Sure. So what's the job?
I want you to help Sam and Paulie with the shipment we've got coming in tonight.
The good stuff?
Straight from Canada.
Where do you need me?
Sam's gone to meet our friends from the north at the farm outside of town. Paulie will oversee the trucks bringing the shipment into the city, but I want you to go with him. Be an extra pair of eyes. Make sure it all goes smoothly.
Okay.
Get the car from Ralphie and meet Paulie at the warehouse. He's got heaters in case you run into any trouble.
Sure, Frank. No problem.
Good. Now bring the Canadian home safe, Tommy. There is already a case earmarked for the Don.
Thanks, Ralph.
The radio now brings you a special weather report. The heavens have opened, folks, and we're experiencing some adverse effects.
Done a few pickups at the farm before. Don't worry. There ain't nothing but cow shit and shine out here. It's gonna be an easy few clams. Boys will load up the trucks. We'll come straight back.
Yeah, let's make it quick. I got someplace to be.
You see it's there later. Luigi's little girl, your night shift. You're something else, pal. Protecting the girl's virginity one day and taking it the next.
Lay off, Polly.
Ah, come on. I'm just kidding. She's a good girl. You settle down, she'll straighten you right out. You're going home to a couch. Now, I wonder what kind of story she could tell about her old man, though. Luigi was a stone-cold killer back in the day.
I wouldn't know.
You know she's been helping out behind the bar since she was a kid. I bet she's seen and heard a few things. Probably knows more about our business than we do.
She knows enough not to ask me too many questions.
That's good. She won't ever make a liar out of you. Christ. You ought to marry her just for that. Damn it. Sam should be waiting here, but I don't see him.
Something smells off.
Don't let your pecker get all shriveled up. Probably just trying to get out of the rain. Or into the bootleg. That'll wake him.
He ain't coming.
Okay. Let's go find them. That bastard is just three sheets, and I'm wrecking a new suit for nothing. I swear I'm gonna kill him. Here, just in case Frank was right. I'm gonna go grab them boys, get them sorted out. You go ahead, see what's what. We'll catch up with you.
Dog.
don't feel right.
You first.
We don't have time for this.
Sorry, pal. Guess we're doing this the hard way.
Okay, then.
Get over here! I got him pinned down!
Bastard must have taken longer to die.
Wow! It's me, Tom!
Polly! What took you so long?
Looking for Sammy. Did you find him?
Nah, not yet. Just him.
Canadian crew. Dollars to donuts to rest the face down in the dirt, too. Oh, Christ. They're cops, Tommy.
Well, how would I know? They didn't show a badge. Didn't say anything.
They must be in Morello's pocket. This bastard. He can't even let us have this one racket. Forget about it, Tom. We gotta find Sam and get out of here.
From the Border Patrol.
Fuck. They've come heavy, all right. Make Lost Heaven PD look like pussycats.
Okay, we search the farm, find Sam, get the hell out.
You don't want to see this.
Jesus.
Looks like we found the Canadians. See Sam in there?
No.
Glad some.
Poor bastards.
Boys, stay here and watch our backs. Plug anyone who gets within 100 yards. Except us. Can you walk?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, just hang on. I'll go get the truck, then we'll take you to the doctor. Hey, you're gonna make it, Sam. Tommy, You stay here with him. I'll be back in a flash.
Okay. It'll be okay, Sam. We survived worse.
You sure we have? And Donnie too?
Yeah.
What a fucking massacre. How's Sam?
Well, he ain't any worse.
I'll go get him. Keep an eye out. Somewhere. When they pull in behind you, blast them to hell. Just don't let them get past us.
That thing back there is huge. Where the hell did they find that truck?
Thank you. faster!
My pedal is to the metal! Did we lose them?
Two squad cars on us!
There's more!
Get so close! Come
out! These guys keep on coming!
More bad news! Coming in from the side!
Ah, crap! They're right on our ass!
Get so close!
What are you doing here so late?
Evening, Doc. Sorry to wake you, but We had a little accident. We got an injured man out here.
All right, bring him inside.
Okay, thank you. Okay, I'll stay with Sam. You can take the truck back. Call it a night.
No, I'll wait.
The doc's already got his hands full. No sense in both of us breathing down his neck.
Go on, Doc. I'm gonna be fine. Okay.
Hey. You did good tonight.
You're late. Dinner's cold.
Work. Marry me.